What? I want to be in it so you guys see this, so you can get an example. So this growing around me, guys, is what we call cypress knees, like a knee of the cypress tree. So science has stumped us for generations. We cannot figure out why these knees, these pointy things, even exist. At first we thought it helped the tree breathe because it grows in water. But then we did some science stuff and we figured out that's not true. And then we thought that maybe it was to help us anchoring so these things don't fall over in storms. But then we did some more science stuff, found out that the majority of the cypress trees don't have any knees at all, while some of them will have a lot. So that wasn't true. So believe it or not, the best hypothesis, a hypothesis in science means an idea, like an explanation. It's not proven, it's just an idea. But the best idea that we have in science why these trees have spikes is because of mastodons, those big hairy giant elephants. We're finding cypress needles, the vegetation of this tree, we're finding cypress in mastodon poop, in fossilized mastodon poop, suggesting that mastodon, these big hairy elephants, would have fed on this stuff. Remember in Florida, there was 20-foot tall giant sloths roaming around here. And these big hairy elephants and stuff. So we wonder if they evolved to have these spikes to keep the mastodons and these giant sloths away. Because if I'm a big giant mastodon trying to walk through this, I'm gonna trip and I'm gonna fall. If I'm a 5,000-pound animal and I fall on these spikes, it's gonna pierce right through me like knives and kill me. So they think that these knees are actually a defense mechanism. They think the same thing with locust trees, how they have thorns. They think that that tree grew thorns to keep those hairy elephants away. Because this would keep mastodons from entering deep into the cypress and annihilating everything. If they had these knees, then the mastodons would only feed on the edges of the forest. It makes sense. Yeah. But it's actually like the best idea that we can actually come up with science right now. Mm-hmm. I think that's cool. These might exist because of giant hairy elephants. I mean, it's wild. It makes me wonder how many times if I pee on a plant, it might change. Yeah? Like, what are you going to find in my fossilized poop? And what